Hey guys, it's me, Kaylee. Today's lesson is on dividing and using our remainder as a fraction. So make sure you've already watched the videos about division in general so that you know how to get started. All right, let's go. So we're going to start with a simple problem with single digits. So here it says 4 divided by 3. I'm going to write it in standard form. So it's 3 goes into 4 how many times? So I know 3 goes into 4 one time. 1 times 3 is 3. And I'm going to subtract those. I get a 1. And then I'm going to say 3 goes into 1. I know it can't go in a whole number of times. So I would say my remainder is 1. Right, so this is doing division where I'm writing my remainder as a whole number like this. But in this lesson, we're learning how to write our remainder as a fraction. So what I do to write my remainder of 1 as a fraction is I take my remainder, a 1, I put it as the numerator of my fraction, and then I take my divisor, which is this number over 3 over here, and 3 becomes my denominator. So let's try it again. If I say 3 goes into 4, I know it goes in one time. 1 times 3 is 3. I subtract these. I have 1 left over. I'm at this point here where I say my remainder is 1. So I'm going to say my remainder is 1. Remember, it goes in the numerator. And then my divisor, which is 3, goes in the denominator. So now I've written my remainder of 1 here as a fraction, 1/3. So I can say 4 divided by 3 is equal to 1 and 1/3. All right, let's try some harder problems together. All right, so it's 19 divided by 7, so let's write it out. So 7 goes into 19 how many times? From your fact families, 7 times 2 is 14. So we can put a 2 up here. 2 times 7, we got a 14 there. We're going to subtract these. 19 minus 14, that gives us 5. So we would say 5 remainder, we're writing as a fraction. So remember, we take our remainder, we divide it by our divisor, so we get 5 over 7 up there. And looks like that's our answer there. So great job. I wonder if you've made the connection now after we've done a few of these. Remember when we write a fraction, let's take our remainder here. So 5 over 7 is the same as saying 5 divided by 7. Okay, so that's how we're getting to this fraction here from our division at this point. All right, here it says 64 divided by 30. So we're gonna do this division, and then when we find a remainder, we're going to write it as a fraction, as you can see here in our answer choices. So let's set it up to start. So we know that it's going to be 30 divided into 64. So you might know from your fact family that 30 goes into 60 two times. So 30 times 2 is 60, so I can put a 2 up here. And I say 2 times 30, I multiply these, give me 60. I subtract this, I have a 4 remaining. So now it says 30 goes into 4 how many times? Well, we know it doesn't go in an equal time, so traditionally I would write this as my remainder of 4. But now I'm writing this as a fraction. So what I'm actually going to have is I'm going to have my 2 remainder 4 is going to be rewritten as a fraction. So it'll be 2 is going to be 4 on top of whatever I'm dividing by, which is my 30. But I can simplify this fraction, right? They both are divisible by 2. So if I divide each of these by 2, I'll have a 2 on top and a 15 on the bottom. So my answer comes to 2 and 2/15, which looks like this top answer here. Great job learning how to write your remainders as a fraction. Now go ahead and practice what you've learned by doing the online games and quizzes. Have fun and remember to always be clever. Hey, hey.